So this preaching of today is going to help you to move to where God wants you to be.
John 14.
Let's read John 14, verse 6.
John 14, verse 6.
So my way to move is truth. We must stand in truth. In John 8:32, you will know the truth. And the truth itself will set you free. In other words, we become free to move by the truth. Without truth, we are stagnant. We are bound to one place. Confined to one place. There's a penalty or something that happened when you are guilty. You become guilty when you are not living the life of truth. And now you get penalty. To come out of that penalty is when you found the truth. There's freedom in truth. A person who's having truth, even when his life seems to be like he's staggering, but he's going towards where God is going. Truth takes you to the salvation where God wants you to be. John 4, verse 15. Listen to this. Unless you have truth, no one will help you. We normally fake the things of the Spirit, but you cannot fake the truth. Ephesians 6, verse 4. Truth involves two things: personal integrity and moral courage. Stand in truth. Don't be afraid of what you are going through. And try to find answers in a very simple way. You are not assigned for the simple way. You are pressed to produce the best. There are times where you have to be pressed because there is something that is searching for something that is in you. Allow this thing to press you very soon. There will be overflow. I see overflow coming your way. If you believe, say amen. Amen. Luke 15, verse 10. If we read James 1, verse 22.
Jacob 1.
Let's read that verse.
It's verse 22.
Is very much challenging.
It challenges our
whole. As a child of God, you must have truth. You must have truth. It's not the car that this person is driving. If a person comes to your way and
say
he loves you and is older than you and you want to get married, why don't you ask, are you not married? If the person says no, I say, okay, come to my pastor. You have the truth. You say, come to my pastor. That person won't come because there's someone at home. There's a way of stopping nonsense. I don't know if you're hearing. The reasons why we are being tempted and we fall, get out of the truth, is because of your observance. It's not judged by the word of God.
Our
focus is being taken by many things. I don't know if you hear me. So deal with your focus.
Right.
Deal with my focus.
2 Peter chapter 2.
Verse 2 and 3.
Proverbs 29:27.
When you are wicked, you are also attracted by the wicked. But the Bible says the righteous is repulsive. The moment when you are standing with a wicked person, something is not right here. Yeah, it's like this. This is a wrong something. So you cannot just make friendship. You cannot just end up saying, it's my friend. You cannot just have friends. Look at your phone. Some characters are coming from your phone. The wicked are your friends.
Because
you cannot discern. It's very easy to deal with people who lie. Standing the truth, they will run away. I don't know if you're hearing me. It's very easy. Because many people who don't live the life of truth, they don't know that the Holy Spirit is everywhere. He was there when you were proposing that game. He was there when you were robbing other people's
children.
He was there when you were lying to your parents. He was there when you were thinking your thoughts. He was there, he was everywhere. The moment when you understand
this
everywhere, you will have fear to act in a wrong way. I pray that today, you must know that you are not hidden. You are exposed to the Holy Spirit. You are on the eyes of the living God.
So
live the life of the truth, and God will save you. This is your way to move forward. If we have the truth, this is the last thing, we'll expose each other to the truth. We'll expose each other to the truth. The Bible says, he
will
see, tell another one, pray together, and the Lord will forgive.
And
I'm stopping there.